You and me, we both have this dream.
Yeah, I guess we do.
Hey, we'll be famous. We'll show them.
Watch out, here we come. To be or not to be.
It's not gonna happen for you. Not in a million years.
But after that? This town, Greg. They don't want me.
Wish we could just make our own movie.
A great idea.
What was your initial reaction going back to that very first time you watched The Room? Do you recall?
Yes, I do. I did not do it the right way. I watched it alone. And you're not supposed to watch The Room alone because you need to kind of turn to someone else and be like, what the hell is going on right now? But my first like experience after that was at one of the midnight screenings where people are going crazy. And so that was the way to see it.
This movie is really like the epitome of the best Toronto movie in the sense that people come here with their stuff. They're like, oh boy, get ready, America. And then in a moment, it could all be dashed. This is the worst version of this. I mean, not every movie that comes to Toronto is great.
It's a very meta experience doing a movie about making a movie and about your hopes and dreams.
Yeah.
For a movie, being at a film festival where everyone has a lot of hopes and dreams about
that's true.
Yeah.
That's true. Wow, that is very meta.
Yeah, look at that. That's the kind of that's the wisdom
we're
delivering.
You know what I mean? This is where we're at.
I think we got it.
So thank you so much for coming.
It was a pleasure.
And we hope your hopes and dreams go well.
We have a gift bag over there. You can just grab anything.
So now stepping into this role of Greg Sestero and working alongside your brother here. But on set, like, how'd you keep it together? Because, like, James is like, I feel like he just stayed a standing character the whole time.
Yeah. It was hard. It was hard because that's my brother looking like that and talking in a weird, bizarre Eastern European accent. It took a couple days, but I can't say the same for everyone else because certain people were popping in for one day at a time and they would come in and I would have to warn them, like, hey, you're not going to be around James Franco today. Like, it's Tommy Wiseau, so get ready.
It wasn't that he never broke character like, hey guys, please only refer to me as Tommy, but he's in this look and it's such brilliant, subtle makeup, but he had these prosthetics, like an eye and a thing. And so we'd be in the middle of a scene and he'd be like, yeah, okay, I like do it faster. And you're like, is this a Tommy thing? Is this a James thing? And so it was like all sort of the same.
But it would also be like James, it would be like, do you see the trailer for a Star Wars movie? Like, you know, like, oh, just having normal James conversation, Tommy.
What are you guys talking about? What are you talking about? You saw a movie last night.
Yeah, Leia, what did you see? Did you tape that show, that DVR, that show? The funny thing about Franco, too, is like, I forgot what he looked like.
I love watching Big Brother 21. I think it's my favorite.
Bachelorette this season's great. She's fantastic.
Who's she gonna pick, you know?
Is this a movie for, you know, fans of The Room or for anybody? Like, some people aren't familiar with the movie. You think they're still gonna like be able to take something away from this?
When we were first making the movie, we thought that fans of The Room are gonna love this. How do we make it appealing to people who have never even heard of The Room? And again, just going back to this very relatable theme throughout of just going after your dreams. And I think no matter what your occupation is, you can relate to that. Even going into the first big screening at South by Southwest, I wasn't nervous just because I'm like, we like this. We did exactly what we wanted to do. If people don't like it, that sucks. But hey, what else can we do? We made the movie we wanted to make.
It's really a love letter to him and to this film and to have this sort of dream of now. It's like it's a celebration of him in this movie.
We're all dreamers, but sometimes you wake up from that dream. And that's kind of what happened to Tommy. Like his dream just, it didn't come out the way he wanted to, but it came out in a weird reverse way where I think he's made more money from the fact that it was a failure than it would ever be for a success.
This is not necessary.
No, very necessary. I need to show my ass to sell this movie.
I think you're aiming a little bit.
I am what I aim. Just do the scene.
Why is he having sex with her belly button? He knows where her vagina is, right?